Good morning. News bulletin for today is a preventive high-tech vest. Doctors at the Ohio State University Richard M. Ross Heart Hospital are testing a high-tech vest which measures fluid inside the lungs from outside a person's clothing. The Sensi vest has been created by Sensible Medical that uses radar technology. This technology has been miniaturized and put into a form that allows the radar to go through the chest wall and get an accurate measurement of water inside the lungs. Currently, doctors are testing the vest in a national randomized clinical trial to see if it effectively monitors and manages lung fluid, reduces hospitalizations, and improves quality of life. DNA delivery technology for fighting bacteria. New breakthrough technology from Tel Aviv University at Israel facilitates DNA delivery into drug-resistant bacterial pathogens, enabling their manipulation. The research expands the range of bacteriophages, which are the primary tool for introducing DNA into pathogenic bacteria to neutralize their lethal activity. For the research, the team genetically engineered bacteriophages to contain the desired DNA rather than their own genome. This could pave the way to changing the human microbiome, the combined genetic material of the microorganisms in humans, by replacing virulent bacteria with avirulent bacteria and replacing antibiotic-resistant bacteria with antibiotic-sensitive bacteria, as well as changing environmental pathogens. Nanomaterial for promoting bone growth. There hasn't been a gold standard for how orthopedic spine surgeons promote new bone growth in patients, but now Northwestern University scientists have designed a bioactive nanomaterial for stimulating bone regeneration, and it could become the method surgeons prefer. In the new nanomaterial, sugar molecules are displayed in the scaffold built from self-assembling molecules known as peptide amphiphiles. These synthetic sugar molecules on the surface of the nanomaterial provide its regenerative power. The Northwestern research team plans to seek approval from the FDA to launch a clinical trial studying the nanomaterial for bone regeneration in humans. Longevity of airborne viruses. Queensland University of Technology and the University of Queensland scientists have developed a new technique to study how some common disease-causing bacteria can remain alive in the air for up to 45 minutes. This research is possibly one of the first to study the longevity of airborne Pseudomonas aeruginosa bacteria, a multi-drug-resistant germ associated with hospital-acquired infections when they are expelled by human cough or sneeze. It was found that Pseudomonas aeruginosa bacteria are resistant to rapid biological decay and thus remain viable in room air long enough to form an airborne infection risk, especially with people having respiratory problems such as cystic fibrosis. These findings have implications for infection control in hospitals, particularly with people getting treated with cystic fibrosis. Thank you.